A new era in Belen high school football has started. The question is, can the rookie head coach return the Eagles to the old days when Belen was a gridiron power? Van Tate has the story on the road.
Up. He's pretty good. He's a hard worker. He likes to work us hard and just all out good coach. He knows everything, technique, fundamentals.
He's a swim.
He has a good discipline, which the team needs this year, and we haven't had before, and he's a real workhorse. We
both power on red.
Football players at Belen High School have good things to say about Mike Nesbitt. He's a former University of New Mexico punter who has returned to his high school roots. Once a star, now the Eagles head football coach.
I'm trying to get these seniors and other people to understand is the fact that we've had good football teams here in the past at Belen High School. But these guys are all so young that they never realize it. They've never heard about it or anything like that. And I think that's the big thing is for them to know that there is tradition here.
Returning home to coach will be no easy task, and Nesbitt has already been warned by his former college coach.
He said he went back to Kansas and did something similar to what I've done. And he said it was just hard. It was a lot of work. Everybody expects a lot of good things from your team. You just got to be prepared for it.
The good news for Coach Nesbitt is that he'll get help meeting expectations. He likes what he sees in returning players.
Left me in pretty good shape. I've got some good returning skill guys. We're pretty solid at tight end with Mondo Sanchez and one of our wide receivers with Bobby West. We're in pretty good setting with that.
Socorro is the first team Nesbitt will face as Eagles head coach.
I really don't know what it'll be like the first night. It'll probably be just like everything else, you know, the first meeting with the team. It's kind of different trying to be the one to be out in front of everybody now instead of being the player and sitting there in the stands and listening to the coach talk.
Belen will host Socorro August 29th. Van Tate on the road, Belen.
Thank you.
quarter, it's Josh Barella with the touchdown pass to Barella with the TD for Socorro. They go up 14-6. Later, second quarter, Terry Rother, 80-yard TD pass, and he'll go down the sideline, coming right at you. He'll get into the end zone. It's 23-6 Socorro at that point. Around 300 yards passing in the first half for Socorro, and they go on to win it tonight by a final of 36-20.
Come on, Eagles!
working well early on. It's Edwin Zamora who takes it in. The extra point no good in the first quarter, 6-0. Later on, a second pitch, this time to Joseph Salas, who goes on in 14-0 after the two-point conversion was good. The fourth quarter finally ends the shutout streak. Watch Aaron Jaramillo run into his own player, but he also finds the end zone. In the end, though, it's Rio Grande, 28-14, your final score.
Thank you.
Elliott in from short yardage, and it's 28-love, Belen. Then the pitch from Elliott in the house again. 35-0, Belen is your final.
Today against Belen, Albuquerque High quarterback Carlos Romero did not play. Belen's Lance Murray did, had a pretty good game. Throws the touchdown pass to Mondo Sanchez. Eagles up 21-0 at half. Number 83, Sean Hightower, was in at quarterback for Romero, and he basically got hammered, fumbled the ball. Belen recovered. Eagles fly down the field. Dennis Elliott gets the points on this one, and Belen wins it 35-0.
Thank you. The Belen Eagle defense dominated the Yelp offense in the first half. The defense was led by seniors Mondo Sanchez and Brian McCartney. Lance Murray soared to the air 21 times in the game and completed 11 passes. He threw for 3 touchdowns. The final score was 47-12 as Belen has the winner. This is Bryce Minnick reporting for Belen for Friday Night Football Flight.
Pictures to prove it. Sets the stage for a big-time win. Aaron Jaramillo with the 11-yard touchdown run puts the Eagles up 21-0. Short time later, more Belen scoring. Gabriel Nanez, this time on the highlight reel. He takes it in for the short score. Belen's up 27-0. The lone highlight for Gallup, Carlos Torres on the kickoff. Keep your eyes on him because he is going to go the other way, 90 yards. But I'll tell you what, let's cut to the chase. It didn't do much good. Belen wins it 47-12.
Here we go against Cibolo, first district game.
Touchdown. Thank you.
stopping the Belen Eagles. All I want to know is, where's Dorothy and Toto? Third quarter, Belen takes the lead. Dennis Elliott, one of two touchdown runs. It's 15-14 Eagles. Later, it's 22-14, and that's when Cibola comes back. Fourth quarter, Greg Ward, 45 yards. How did he do that? That's what I want to know. 45 yards, it's 22-20. Cibola down by a pair. Still later, back to pass, and Abreu, the freshman, looking for Anthony Devereaux over the middle, breaks one tackle, and goes on into the end zone. That's your game winner, 28-22 Cibola.
The lead, Dennis Elliott. This is his second touchdown of the night. Streaks down the sideline. It is 15-14 Belen, and it looks like the Eagles are going to put this one in the bag. Mondo Sanchez steps in front of Eddie Abreu's pass, makes a couple of dance steps on his way to the promised land, and it is 22-14 Belen in the fourth. But Cibola goes on a crazy rally. Look at Greg Ward. I don't know how he escapes all the white shirts, but he does, and he finds Happy Land. The Cougars do not convert on the two-point conversion, so they still trail 22-20. Then, with about a minute to go, they get the ball back. Abreu to Anthony Devereaux. A couple of tackles are gone, and so is he. Cibola pulls out a great victory for them. It hurts for Belen. 28-22 is the final.
Thank you.
Sevieri goes on in first quarter, and El Dorado takes a 14-0 lead at that point. Last seconds of the first quarter, Belen quarterback Lance Murray hooks up with Mondo Sanchez. 57-yard pass play to the two, and then that sets up a 4-yard TD pass from Murray to Aaron Jaramillo. 14-7, El Dorado led at that point, and they go on to win it by a final of 28-7.
Going end zone, nice grab by David Gilmore. The Orange Eagles lead 21-7. To the fourth, El Dorado takes a 3-touchdown lead. Mike Stone rolling in. El Dorado hangs on to beat Belen 28-27.
Oh, yeah.
Good yardage, but El Dorado's defense won't break. David Gilmore picks Murray on the goal line, eventually tackle him, but it will lead to points.
The Cowboys will tell you, you got to get in the end zone.
That's right, Mike Stone. Go, Speed Racer, go. He's got legs like ours.
But he uses them better than we do.
Yes, very much better. 7-0 El Dorado. They continue to get the good defense as well. Adam Seary, thank you, sir. May I have another? What a hit. He breaks at the pass, almost decapitates the receiver to boot. More El Dorado points. Donnie Sevieri, gotta love him, plows in on the next drive. El Dorado wins this one 28-7.
Go!
fourth quarter. Down 8-6, Sal Nevarez comes at Van. Van, hold your ground. Nevarez goes into the end zone. 12-8 at that point. The extra point, no good. Later, up the middle. Nice running here by Steve Duran. And 65 yards later, it is 6. Sandia manages to hang on and get the win, 25-14. Denares does a little Barry Sanders thing. Nothing there, so he'll go this year hosting Belen, who's still looking for their first win. Eagles look like they might get it. Dennis Elliott around the left end. Belen opened an 8-6 lead in the first half, but Sandia owned the second half. Sal Nevarez goes right. There was nothing there. So he reverses, and he finds there's...
Thank you. Yeah.